trying this. So let us say we are not really sure about the current incentive structure. So we are open to ideas. Okay. Now how do we structure this? Are all of these points clear? For those who have come in late, the problem basically is that Uber wants to increase the number of drivers that they have in India, and we have narrowed it down to cities in which Uber basically operates.
So these cities are the metropolitan
cities. Huh. So what are the two points involved? What are the two main things that we have to attack?
Increase demand.
The demand is already there. It's the supply that we're working on.
The vacuum of supply, basically, how the shortage.
Incentives to what create supply. Of
sorry.
Incentives to create supply of drivers.
Incentives.
On the basis of current, what is available?
Sorry.
To them. I mean, what is current system available for the driver? I mean, what they are doing.
So let's say that we don't know that right now.
Yeah, targeting people who will be like from where we can get drivers.
These are the two questions that we have to solve for. Okay. First of all, who is a potential driver? And once we have a list of people who can be potential drivers for us, what will be the incentive structure to get them on board? Right. So, is this point clear why we have divided the problem in two parts? So, we can have an excellent incentive structure, but if we feel that there are no people available, right, we can't go ahead with incentive. Again, the incentive structure is inherently dependent upon who we are targeting. Right. Let us say I want to become an Uber driver versus a person who's coming from rural India to Delhi, and that person wants to become an Uber driver. The incentives that Uber can offer to us are going to be very different. So before we look at incentives, we have to look at who are the potential target groups for us. Yeah, Ashna.
So are we looking only at the drivers or drivers who have cars? Because
great clarifying question. So Uber has a model in which Uber does not provide the car, right? People have to come up with their own car and they basically are on the network. So just having drivers might not be enough. We need to have cars also. So this divides our where into two parts, two possible strategies. One are drivers plus cars. So this is one kind of thing that we have to look for. Second could be we have to look for both drivers and the way to find cars. These are two different strategies that we can suggest.
And you are driving on a full-time basis, you said?
Huh. Then we can say full-time or part-time.
I think at this stage it would augur well for us to see if the cars, the current structure of Uber operators. Because from what my knowledge is, there are a few, let's call them ठेकेदार or middlemen who have a lot of cars.
Right.
And who employ a lot
they subject to drivers basically.
To drive their own cars.
Ha.
So is this structure very prevalent or something we should look at, mm-hmm. if it is? And therefore, we should then target our incentives to encourage these middlemen.
Mm-hmm.
Or if this is not very prevalent, if there are individual drivers who are driving their own cars, then
you
should have incentives catered to them.
Okay. So let us say, because this one second prince, because we are looking at all possible strategies, let us say that both of these are our target groups.
They are target.
They can be, they are protected, because there's no third category, right? Uber basically works by these two models.
Alright, so basically what I'm understanding is, in the middleman thing, which is basically what the model is, a person who has money buys a car, employs a driver,
yes.
And asks Uber to get him on the network.
Yes.
Right. So basically, he's financing the car.
Huh.
Right. So the finance comes from the middleman.
Yes.
Now, if I want to target an individual formerly rural guy who just migrated to Delhi, I will tell him, hey man, I finance your car and you pay back the money.
Exactly. So, for this type of people,
Uber finance.
Uber can have partnerships with other firms to basically facilitate financing. So, finance is one aspect of it. What else is required?
The network, how do these people get on board with Uber?
Okay. ठीक है, so how do you get on board?
So marketing it, right? How do you market to people? So Uber sends out random emails, I get random emails of I can
if you want to be a driver.
Yeah, but then they're targeting people who have an email ID, who have an internet account.
Mm-hmm.
Now, if I'm trying to look at the other side of people who just, let's say, who don't have money for a car and maybe also not for a computer, then they will have to use other marketing techniques.
Fair enough. So let's do one thing now. Okay. Let's try to make a structure for who can be a potential driver. Okay. Forget the car issue for now. Just let's try to see the number of people who are there and how can we segment them into possible drivers. No, but that is something we can look at. So, does anyone have a structure? I'll share the first step that I made. So we have to solve two things. Find driver. So I first divided the target population into two groups. People who are already driving professionally in some capacity and people who are involved in some other profession altogether. We don't have any such criteria right now. Women.
So, you mean we are not including women in this?
We are not ignoring them at all. So, let us say for now, let us solve the case assuming that they are first trying to exhaust the supply of male drivers.
Okay.
So, is this division clear? Why we are dividing into first people who are already driving and who are not driving? Because the incentives and the kind of support that you have to give them are completely different. Okay. Now we have to further divide them into certain categories.
So already driving, we have to divide into the various competitors. Which is when you say already driving, it means driving a taxi, right?
Yeah.
I didn't say that.
No, you said professional.
Professionally driving.
Professionally driving. They are drivers, what we call drivers. They could be driving anything.
So you don't drive to earn money.
Yeah,
so they could be driving anything.
Have you been driving anything?
Basically, they have the skills to drive.
They have the skills to drive, basically.
Drive to earn money, right?
Drive to earn money. But that's it.
Wait, I'm sorry.
Yeah.
Another important thing is even if he has a particular skill of driving, there are regulations. For example,
all those can be worked out. Okay. See, the points about regulation, how do we get them on board, everything, that will come in later. First of all, we want to see who can we potentially get on board. Okay. And then we'll try to see, okay, of all the possible, let us say, our aim is to find 8 target groups. Right? Then we'll do the next analysis to see, given regulations, given their financial status, which are the target groups which are easier to attack first. Exhaust them, then move on to the next category, The agenda here is just to identify who are the possible people. Yeah.
I might be taking a back step, I'm sorry for that, but then when he said already a driver, not a driver, do you mean already a professional driver?
Yes.
Or a person who knows how to drive?
No, a professional driver.
A professional driver,
right.
Which means a person who can drive a vehicle, a
car,
commercial,
truck,
anything.
Basically, non-co. Okay. Also, I think it's more prudent to divide them between city and intercity.
Fair enough. So, this is the idea here is that you can go ahead and do any kind of niche that you want. Okay.
Divide cars further intercity.
Okay. Intercity. And
intercity.
Sorry.
No, but it's more prudent to target and. A guy who's driving a three-wheeler shifting to a four-wheeler intercity than a guy who's driving a four-wheeler intracity.
So maybe that what, maybe in this case, after we look at car, maybe not at this stage, but at this after that. That is the stage where we divide them into intra and intercity. See, again, opinions can diverge about how.
In my opinion, car and non-car should come after intercity and intracity.
Fair enough, okay. So, just 1 second. Okay. So I can divide car and non-car here.
So
fair enough?
Then we should clarify intercity and intercity the objective itself. Are we targeting only the intercity drivers?
We don't care.
Like to be overall.
Right. So alright, see the objective again is whether we can get them on board easy or not is a moot point. The first thing that we have to look at is who are the possible target groups. And then we'll rank them on the ease and rather the least amount of incentives that we have to give to get a certain category on board. So now try to just meet this as far as possible. Okay. And let's see whether we can end with 8 to 12 target categories.
I think you should also divide them into how many of them are already ready for Uber and how many don't.
Fair enough. So car mein what we can do? So let's look at car.
App-based taxi drivers and others.
App and others. Okay. App may then be further divided into
Uber and Ola.
Uber. Ola.
And others that we can further divide into trucks.
That's non-car.
Others are private firms that private taxi firms.
Service. Private taxi firms. Others I can divide into two categories.
Corporate and non-corporate.
Others government taxi.
Wait a second.
We should divide them into those which have the capacity to become Uber drivers because of their newer cars or maybe technological skills to become an Uber driver, and those who cannot become Uber drivers.
The only problem with that is because that will require me to ask a lot of questions about what are the parameters on the basis of which we decide whether someone is eligible to be or not.
I think
the others there, they should be divided into whether they own a car or not.
Okay, so the idea is we can go ahead and divide this into whichever way we want as far as it seems logical. The objective of doing this exercise was that don't start thinking of possible categories on top of your head. Try to divide them into two categories and you will see that you can find a lot of different categories. So I can divide it into koi bhi bata do, any suggestion you want.
Kali Pili
and?
Private
Kali. Non-car mein what do we do?
Trucks.
Heavy commercial vehicles,
yes.
And light commercial.
Trucks.
Yahan pe?
Two wheelers.
Traveler. Aise karke we can basically divide them into different categories. Okay. This is just people who are already a driver. Okay. Ab let us see how can we look at people who are not a driver. Yeah.
So if I don't do that distinction,
that's fine. See, again, वही बात है. If you try to do a distinction and the interviewer disagrees with you, they will say, okay, fine, let's not do this.
But if I completely negate it, because it's more complicated, because there are both of them use the same app, right? One driver.
Fair, they do. So I would just say app and let's say others, and I just have a maybe further divide them into two categories. Okay. Again, so there is no fixed way of doing this MISI. Okay. This was the first idea that I had. And then I started doing it further on, so I had some structure. Maybe in the very first step, you might have divided them into two different categories altogether. Okay. not a driver, how can we see? Again, all ideas work. Let's just see one of them.
Owning a car and walking a car, do we
bring
it here?
Knows how to drive, but he can be trained on.
Owners, non-owner.
Owners can be divided into income segments.
Okay.
Are we actually focusing on the problem? I think we are drifting away from the problem statement because the people.
It doesn't matter. Basically, let's try to structure it.
The people who know driving. For a matter of fact, I may know driving, but I will not take up this job. So, like, why am I even?
Actually, has a fair point. That is why my first VC in this was.
Why will I waste my time even 1 minute on
this? My first missy was full time and part time.
ठीक
है. Instead of dividing them knows and don't know, पहले मैंने से full और part time किया था. ठीक है. उसके बाद I further went with this. ठीक है. Because for people who don't want to become, ठीक है. But people like you will be covered perhaps in this or this category. ठीक है. What we have to do is we have to come up with a structure to differentiate the categories first. How do I know in which category I have to put you and completely not target you? Uske liye we have to make this tree and have the population divided into relevant groups.
Okay.
It is not a mere seeking the solution here that yehi particular target group aana hai. We have to get the complete set and decide, okay, these are the ones that I have to target, these are the ones I have to eliminate. Okay. So we can divide them into whichever way you want. But again, the focus here was have a tree. In a strategy case, you have to be very particular about the tree you are making. Chalo, let us say we have 8 or 9 categories that you decide ki karna hai. If you have to decide the incentive model in a structured fashion, how will we do it?
Monetary incentives and non-monetary.
Correct. ठीक है.
We should look at current incentives which are being offered.
Let us say that current incentives we are already aware of, and let us see the whole range of it. जो भी current होगा उसमें से we'll ignore them.
Fixed
medium.
What would really be non-monetary incentive to become a driver?
Lesson.
Can someone mention that? Abhishek, आप बताओ.
Lesser number of hours to work. Lesser number of trips to get the bonus.
Lesser trips. Okay. So I'll tell you something that one of the taxi aggregator had done.
Okay.
So they paired up with a NGO, okay, which provides education to children. So they said, come and drive for us and we'll make sure your child goes to a good school for as long as you're working for us.
Is it too specific?
No, we can. But the idea is to have non-monetary, okay, that they exist. We can find a way to pinpoint very specific strategies later on. But have the structure in place. So monetary, non-monetary, now what?
Monetary may bonus.
Fixed bonus and variable.
Isme fixed and variable? Okay.
जिसने भी फिक्स्ड
लिस्ट किया था
the variable which comes from the driver driving
that's I think great category time based distance based
and for the time based you can also divide into whether they're working night shift should be I think more expensive than the day shifts
ठीक है so basically when the supply is already less if you work So this is one way. Okay. Another is can someone map a process for this and then have this tree in place?
So
let us say you have found a driver and what are the next steps involved?
To convince him.
To convince that person?
First,
the whole life cycle of a driver, let us say. So you found a driver. What do we do next with that guy?
I'm sorry, but then should we focus on how to find a driver first?
So let us say that we have found a driver. So we know which are the categories. So which we know that there are certain categories, okay. Irrespective of which category you are picking from,
right.
Everyone has to go through a certain process after that. So I'll tell you what I mean. So we've got them on board. There might be training. Then there is the job phase. And then there's a post-job phase. So for a case like this, what we are basically doing is with the first step of finding the driver. So initially I divided the problem in two parts, find an incentive. Right? We are able to get certain categories. Let us say 8. Now we are going to explore all of these categories on the basis of these steps. Okay. And then decide, okay, category 1 requires a lot of incentive here, here, and here. Whereas category 7 is does not require anything here, nothing here, here. So maybe let's attack that category first. That is our target category initially. Is that point clear?
Yes, yes.
What do you mean by post-job phase?
You tell me what can be the elements there.
Better ability to take leaves, more leaves.
Okay.
Then better salaries if we are going to have better factors. More leaves, salaries, flexibility in timing.
So family lifestyle. Okay, so I had something else in mind. So whenever you take up employment somewhere, you're always worried about the exit options, right? So let us say I want to be an Uber driver for the next 5 years. After that, what am I planning to do? Right? So are there certain things that we can look at here? So I would put family lifestyle all in the job phase, like while they are working. Okay. So professional and personal. And you have to be further divided. So basically here I am trying to look at opportunities available after work. So yeah, pension. Can we have a pension scheme? What else? One very important thing. So you are a driver.
Insurance.
How are we saving money in like
So, what is the major difference between Ola and Uber?
Payment in cash, right?
No.
But then
Uber also has payment in cash in different cities. Not in Delhi, but in Bangalore.
Now in Delhi also.
Now in Delhi also?
I'm not sure.
Yes. Uber is global, Ola is Indian.
Uber is global and Ola is
Indian. So, one thing would be okay.
Chance to go outside.
Chance to go outside, right? You have to be creative when you're doing this case, right? So, you train them to be international drivers. Uske baad Dubai bheje sabko. Okay. So, keep yourself open. Don't think that any particular idea will not work out. But have a structure in place. Here also I am listing out, but otherwise I would have divided this into certain categories and then gone ahead with it. Okay. So even a case which is very unstructured upfront can be structured if you try to do it. This was the whole idea of this exercise. Is this clear?
So when we say incentives, we would primarily focus on incentives post the job. But why aren't we considering incentives during the job?
I would. If I was in this way, I was, so someone raised the point, what are post-job incentives?
Fine.